Good.
Well, he's been giving us reviews on Chinese food and foot massages. He also stars in the well-reviewed action-packed movie Bumblebee. Please welcome Stephen Schneider. You know, so Stephen, I was one of the unique few who caught an early screening of this, and I knew it was a great movie when the theater erupted in applause. So when did you know that there were positive reviews behind this?
I mean, you never really know when you're filming something. It feels like it's awesome at the time or it feels funny in the moment, but how it's going to all be cobbled together, you know, remains to be seen. I didn't see the movie until the premiere because I'm kind of neurotic, and so I don't want to think about it until I have to, you know, actually have to. And I was blown away. I mean, the movie is so good. It's got a 94% on Rotten Tomatoes.
Wow.
Compared to my wife's first movie, which has a 4.
Do you like hold that over
all
her?
Day? Do you? All day.
Why you gotta do that?
The movie is so good, guys. I mean, it's really crazy because the filmmakers did this awesome job of sort of shifting the franchise in a new direction. They really leaned into character-driven narratives, which is something that fans really wanted. And so the movie has so much heart, and it's funny, it's action-packed, it's really epic. I just saw it in 3D for the third time.
How is that?
Nice.
Rad.
Woo.
Really rad.
Anything people might not expect about that type of movie? Yeah. Like in the filming process, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, so, well, first of all, like if you're a fan of previous Transformer films, you'll appreciate all the action-packed craziness that, you know, Michael Bay is really well known for. What they won't expect is just this incredible, I mean, the filmmakers did such a good job of bringing so much heart and vulnerability to this huge hunk of metal. And I'm not talking about John Cena. I'm talking about the Bumblebee is just zeros and ones. He's just CG. And you really forget that when you're watching the film. And I think that is a testament just to awesome storytelling, phenomenal performances.
What's
amazing
going on here,
animations.
This behind-the-scenes stuff happening here?
Oh, this is just a scene where Haley, who play, you know, Charlie, who is played by Haley Steinfeld, comes in and
who's your stepdaughter?
She's my stepdaughter. I play her stepdad, who is the coolest dad in town, at least in his mind. In reality, he has no job. He's totally out of touch. I'm just playing myself, really, on film. But he's got a huge heart, and he'd
Wait,
do anything
you have a
for
Sally.
Yes, I do.
Yeah. That's pretty cool one.
Especially
yeah.
now.
Pretty
yeah.
great one, yes. Yeah.
Let's go take a look at a clip.
Closer. Closer.
Oh, God.
It's all under control.
Mom? You pull that car over right this second. You have to trust me, please. Charlie! We gotta help her run.
Hang on.
Oh, my gosh. What are you doing?
I saw this on Miami Vice. Oh, I got it.
Oh, my God.
Are you driving like a Camaro or what?
No, that is just an old
family station wagon.
That family station wagon, yeah. That's just how I drive in Boston. That just was just
you gotta be aggressive.
Prepped you perfectly.
Yeah. A couple things I want to point out from that clip. One, the whole theme takes place in the 80s, which is super cool.
Yes, very
even the
cool.
Transformers look like they looked when I was a kid.
Yes, yeah. I was born in 1980. When were you born?
Boom.
Oh,
amazing, amazing. I actually got Optimus Prime for Hanukkah one year.
Right.
And you sort of felt like you were beating the system because it's really two toys in one.
Right. Yeah.
Until my parents found that out, and then they're like, you're not getting a toy on the eighth night, okay?
Oh.
They were giving you two.
Exactly. I'm returning Mousetrap. I mean, I grew up as a huge fan of the Transformers as well.
Well, Stephen, thank you so much, my man.
Yeah, man.
Appreciate
great,
it. Thanks for coming in. Don't forget, Bumblebee in theaters now.
Everywhere. Check it out, guys.